film this, but I was like, okay, well, whatever. I'll just do it. I am gonna finally change this color. It's washed out as much as it can. I could, you know, do the color stripping and strip it out of my hair, but I really don't care. I mean, I don't mind because my hair's not gonna listen to me anyway, so it's probably not even gonna wash out. But this time I bought the Manic Panic brand, and I have one in Rockabilly Blue and the other is After Midnight, and I'm going to mix these two. I made sure to get two jars, so it should definitely cover my entire head. And don't worry, I did the allergy test this time and it hasn't bothered me. I think it washed out my skin so far. What I did learn when I did this allergy test, I'm gonna tell you right now, my hair is not gonna take it as much as it should. I left it in for the entire day, you know, just to see if my skin would get irritated or not. And when I washed it, I didn't even wash it. I just, you know, put water on it to see how much the color would come out. And I think I have a little piece back. I don't know if you can see, but it's a little bit blue, but it was a lot darker before on this piece. And I guess the ends of it turned a little bit purple. So even if it washes out, I don't mind because my hair will be purple instead of orange, red, pink, blonde. But I like purple anyway, so that's why I'm not really that big on rinsing this color out all the way. So since it just came in jars, there's no gloves with it. And I thought I had some at home, but I only have one glove. People usually break it down with cheap conditioner. I have conditioner just in case this doesn't feel like enough for my hair, but I'm gonna try and not break the color down as much as possible because it's gonna wash right out of my hair. I have my Vaseline to protect my skin from being stained, which it'll probably stain anyways. And I have a bowl to mix this dye in, and I think I'll be ready to go. No bleaching, no other stuff gonna go on, just gonna put the color in my hair and have it sit. So I have a lot of dye left over, which is a good thing. So I'm just gonna stick it back into this jar and mix it with the rest of this conditioner. So next time I wash my hair and I condition it, it'll keep putting color back into my hair as it's being washed out of my hair. I added two bags to my hair because I learned my lesson from last time. I didn't add heat to it. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna sit under this bad boy. It's a portable hair dryer. It comes in handy. If you have big hair, you should definitely probably like get one of these if you want, like, don't want to go to the salon and you want to, like, you know, curl your hair and sit under the dryer and all that stuff. Oh, I forgot what I was saying. Hair. Oh, okay, yeah, I'm gonna sit under that for an hour and then I'm just gonna leave it in my head for the entire night and I'll wash it out tomorrow morning. So RIP to everything I touch because it'll probably end up blue. I won't wash it out with shampoo. They said to use vinegar because vinegar helps it bond to your hair and cleans it at the same time. So I'll do that in the morning. I actually changed my mind. I tied the plastic bags a little too tight around my head, so it started giving me a headache. I also took it off because I wanted to see how it would look. So I pulled out a strand of hair and I washed it out in the sink, and it basically stayed the same kind of blue-black color that I wanted in the very, very first place. So I'm gonna go wash it out with vinegar and show you what it looks like. Actually, I don't know if I want to wait until now or show you in the morning. Depends on how sleepy I am. But if it still looks the same like this, then I'll show you in the morning. If it doesn't, then I'll show you tonight. So, yeah. Hey everyone. So this is the final color. Every single thing in this house, I turned it blue, and my hands are like permanently like blue. I rinsed it out with the vinegar, and I will warn you, if you have any cuts or anything, it will burn. And the vinegar ended up getting inside my eyes, so it's just like dyeing vinegar in my eyes, and it was burning, but yeah. The color rinsed out. I used one of those really big gallons. I conditioned it and stuff, but I didn't like the way my hair felt, so I ended up just washing it with shampoo anyways, and the color came out a lot, but not really. You can't even like tell. So it still looks blue. I'm just waiting for the edges of my skin to like wash out and on my hands. Don't judge me on my glasses because I sat on them, so it broke off one of the sides. I can't put any of my contacts or any makeup or anything because I'll just rub more blue into my skin, and my skin stains very easily. So I'm stuck wearing these ones until I can put my contacts back in my eyes. It was a big problem taking them out since I had so much dye on my hands. No matter how much I washed it, it was still on my hands. And you don't want to get dye in your eyes, so I am being very careful, and I'm keeping my glasses on until then. So this is basically it. It's exactly what I wanted. I always wanted a blue-black kind of color. The only problem with coloring your hair like a blue is just that it stains, and every time I touch my hair, the hair has to be wet for me to like comb it or style it or do anything to it. So when I put like conditioner and stuff in it, color will rub off and it'll always get on my hands. And so I'm not sure how that's gonna work out with contacts, but I'll figure something out. But I'm very happy, and the Manic Panic did absolutely a beautiful job in coloring over the pink color. And yeah, so that's it. I won't be coloring my hair anymore, other than, you know, retouching up this if I feel like it. And yeah, so thanks for watching, and have a wonderful night, morning, evening, or afternoon, and I will see you guys very soon. Love you, bye.